guys, Basmus here, and in today's video, we are going to talk about the 5 stages of film production. The first stage is called development. This is where the story idea comes in, the script writing, the script coverage, the organizing, and the planning of a project takes place. In development phase, a preliminary budget is set. So the main actors are auditioning and the main cast are getting attached. The key creatives are set, the main locations are getting scouted, and multiple drafts of a script may be written. This is all just groundwork for the producers to see how much is this project going to cost to make. The development stage can take months to years to make, and sometimes it goes above the limit of how much it should have taken, which causes it to get delayed or sometimes canceled. Now, this can be very chaotic because if it does get canceled, you are stopping a machine from working and it is hard to start back up. But when a development stage is finished, it goes through the green light project. What is green light? Green light is when the studio approves your project and has the investors, the finances, the producers finally on page with you, and it covers the whole budget of your project. And that's where the development stage goes into pre-production. The pre-production stage is the second stage of film production. This is where the script is getting amended, the casts are getting casted, the budget is getting adjusted, the schedules are set, the crew are getting employed, the set designs are happening and being built, the costumes are made and fitted, and everything that has to do with the shoot is already getting planned and tested. Now, the pre-production stage can last up to many months from the initial green lighting of a project to when cameras are actually shooting and rolling. But as the date gets closer and closer, the crew is getting bigger and more people are getting employed about 2 to 8 weeks before the shoot begins. Which leads us to go from pre-production to the third stage of film production, production. Now, this is when the cameras are finally rolling and everything is happening in real life. The production stage is actually the shortest stage out of the 5 stages, which is crazy to me because this is when everything is actually happening right before their eyes. So the director, the producer, they have been there since the development stage and they have been waiting months, maybe years to finally see it, you know, happening. And I bet it is a phenomenal feeling, but this is when everybody is expected to do the job that they've been hired to do perfectly. You cannot mess up or you will be fired and replaced. That is the production stage. It is the busiest time, but it is probably the best time ever, you know, getting to share that with hundreds of employees all working towards the same goal. So, we have came up with an idea, wrote a script, raised enough funds, hired a crew to make it, and spent most of our budget money to get into the 4th stage, post-production stage, which is all about editing. This is when the footage is getting edited, the sound is getting mixed, the visual effects are getting added, the soundtrack is getting composed, the title is getting created, and the project is getting completed for distribution and marketing. Ah, finally! So hours of hard work on production is gonna continue with more hours in post-production. But post-production is beautiful because the footage are getting edited together to create a story. A flowing story for people to watch. I love post-production. But I love production more. But I love both. Post-production can actually start when production starts. Why? Well, that helps the project finish way faster because they're both starting at the same time. Also, when production shoots a scene, they send those shots to post-production where they can start editing, and then they may find some problems with the footages. They may have some missing shots, so they can just go back to production and say, hey, we need those and those shots redone, or maybe we need more shots, so the production can just schedule or add another day to where they can just remake those shots or add more shots and send them over to post-production instead of, you know, stopping production, starting on post-production. Because then if you start post-production way after production has started, then they're going to be like, man, but we need those shots, so we're going to have to start production again. You do not want to go back and forth, you know? So I love how we do production, post-production at the same time. Lastly, we get into marketing and distribution. Distribution and marketing is the final stage in our five stages of film production. This is where the final product wants its investment return and maybe more profit. So the producers, they invested for a reason into this project because they want to make more money, of course. Now, how can we make more money? We have to get the people to view the project. We have to market it. We have to distribute it. So how can they distribute it? They can put it in the cinemas, like the theaters when you go watch a movie. Or maybe sell it to a TV network. Or maybe a streaming service such as Netflix or Hulu. I'm a huge Netflix fan. Or maybe just, you know, directly into DVD. Whatever the producers chooses, it has to work. They have to make their money back and more, or else all the other four stages that they have started with can go to waste. Now, even though this is the final stage, they do plan the marketing and the pre-production because that is a very important stage, and if they fail, they don't make their money. This happened to many people to where they have worked on a project for years, months, and they failed, they didn't make their money back. It's the worst thing that could happen to a project. But if your project succeeds and it's distribution and marketing, then yeah, you make your money back. It becomes the next big movie. It's talked about. The actors are getting famous. The directors are getting known. The producers are making more money and making more projects because now they know how everything works. And yeah, that's when everything comes together and they move on to the next project. Well, thank you for watching my video on the five stages of film production. I hope that was helpful. It is a summary of the five stages. I will be getting into more depth starting with development because I am learning that in college right now. We'll be starting off with like story structure, script writing, script coverage, everything that you need to know, and we'll move on to other stages from there. If you have any questions on the video today, please comment them down below. Don't forget to like, subscribe. I really want to grow this channel with you guys. I want you guys to stick with me and we'll learn all the knowledge that we need to learn because knowledge is power and I love power, of course. So yeah, hope you guys have a good day and see you guys later. Bye bye.